With the midterms a month away, there's new polling in the race for U.S. Senate. We'll hear from the candidates, plus Democratic Party Chair Mike Schmuhl, on the latest controversy in the race for Secretary of State. Plus, we sit down with Congressman Greg Pence and his opponent, Cindy Wirth, and the impact of the president's decision to pardon federal convictions for possessing small amounts of marijuana. It's all ahead right now on this week's edition of In Focus. Thanks so much for joining us. We're now just a month away from the midterm elections, and this week we have some new polling about a couple of statewide races that we've been watching closely. In the race for Secretary of State, the poll from ARW Strategies and IndyPolitics.org this week shows Democratic candidate Destiny Wells ahead of Republican Diego Morales, who's been under scrutiny again after some explosive allegations that we'll talk about here in a moment. This poll taken before news of those allegations broke. We're also talking about the race for Senate, that same poll showing incumbent Todd Young just a couple of points ahead of Mayor Tom McDermott. So what are the candidates saying this week about the poll and about the race for Senate? Our Kristen Eskow has the latest from the campaign trail.
It's one of the biggest races on the ballot this November, as Republican Todd Young seeks a second term in the Senate.
A Marine Corps captain trained in counterintelligence.
Young has focused his campaign on his military background and his work in Washington on measures like the Bipartisan CHIPS Act, which will scale up semiconductor manufacturing.
I'm going to continue to focus on creating an environment where more good manufacturing jobs like the ones that are provided here can continue to be realized.
Young's Democratic opponent, Hammond Mayor Tom McDermott, says he's made abortion rights his top priority following the Dobbs v. Jackson ruling.
It's SB1, it's women's reproductive liberties, it's something that's extremely important, and it opens up a door to a host of other issues as well.
There haven't been many polls released on the race, but a new poll from Indy Politics and ARW Strategies suggests it's a dead heat, with Young up by 2 points over McDermott. 17% of voters remain undecided.
I think it's underreporting the number of first-time women voters that are going to show up that are interested in restoring their civil liberties.
Young says he's not paying much attention to the polling.
I don't spend a whole lot of time looking at anyone's polls. The only polls that matter are on election day.
UND political science professor Laura Wilson points out the poll finds a larger portion of undecided voters than you'd normally see at this point in the campaign.
There's a lot of national issues that are getting attention right now. Gas prices are still going up. Inflation is still a problem. The Supreme Court overturned abortion. And there are a lot of things that I think people are looking at.
Libertarian candidate James Siniak believes the number of voters who may be undecided is telling.
The realism is that people are tired of the two-party system. They want to look for other better options.
All right, Kristen joins me now here in the studio. We're about a week away from these candidates meeting on the debate stage next Sunday night, the 16th. And then we're going to be sitting down with the candidates in a forum that you'll see right here on the 24th. But this past week, they both sadly had to take some personal time away from the campaign trail.
Well, that's right, Dan. Senator Young announced Monday night he was canceling campaign events after announcing that his father had passed away. And then on Wednesday, McDermott announced that his stepfather had passed away, leading both candidates to take a little time away from the trail this past week ahead of that debate next Sunday night.
All right, in the meantime, a lot of developments in these statewide races that we're watching closely, with these latest polls showing some pretty interesting results here of late.
Yeah, and I spoke with the state party chair for the Indiana Democrats about those polling numbers this week, starting with the race for Senate.
You know, I think what the poll shows, and what it's shown actually for the last few months, is that Senator Todd Young is vulnerable in this race. This is a tough election year. Politics is front of mind for people all across Indiana and all across our country. And I think that Todd Young has been trying to find his place sort of representing Indiana and his place in the Republican Party. I think sometimes he sides with Democrats, as he was with a signing with Joe Biden not too long ago. And other times he signs with sort of extreme side of the Republican Party. And so he's sort of a man without an island, a man without a base. And I think it also shows that Tom McDermott's really putting in the work. He's becoming more well-known. He's traveling all around Indiana. He's meeting with people directly. his style, his intensity. He's definitely a fighter. He definitely tells people like it is. I think that his message is really resonating with Hoosiers. At the end of the day, money's not everything. Message is important. Where you stand is important. What your vision is for serving in the United States Senate is important. And I think on those measures, Tom McDermott is doing a great job.
I also wanted to ask you about these allegations facing Diego Morales now over in the Secretary of State's race regarding sexual misconduct. What are your thoughts on the allegations that have been raised and the impact that that could have on that race?
Well, I think number one, we have to trust women and believe women when they come forward with some of these allegations and just the serious nature, the personal nature of these allegations. So number one, we have to believe women, trust women, and applaud their bravery for coming forward. It is not easy. I think number two, it just shows a troubling pattern. We've been saying all along that Diego Morales has more baggage than baggage claim. He's simply unfit to be the next Secretary of State in the state of Indiana. This is somebody who was fired twice from the very office they now seek to lead from previous secretaries of state. So fired twice from this office. There's questionable things in his background relating to his service record in the military, questionable things in his behavior and his background with these women coming forward. And that's just a few things that people can uncover throughout the course of this election. So troubling circumstance to be sure. The good news for Hoosiers and the good news for folks watching is Destiny Wells is a 19-year veteran of the Army. She signed up at 19. She's an attorney. She's a mother. She grew up on a farm. And so she definitely represents Hoosier values, and she is the safe and secure choice to be our next Secretary of State.
I know it was first reported by the Indy Star that one of the women went to Chairman Hupfer over in the GOP with one of these allegations. So I'm wondering, have any women come to you, your party, or the Wells campaign with allegations of sexual misconduct by Diego Morales?
No women have come to me or the Indiana Democratic Party on this front. I think what I would say to the allegations of going to my counterpart on the Republican side of the aisle is how many other folks have known about this over the last few months, few years, few days. I think that's a real question.
Now, GOP Chairman Kyle Hupfer was unavailable this past week for an interview, but in a statement, he told us, quote, "A member of the Republican Party asked me to meet nearly 2 months after our state convention. At the meeting, she shared with me elements of a story that have now been made public. It wasn't then, nor is now, my story to share." He went on to say, "Allegations like these should be fully and fairly vetted, and the accuser, accused, and voters deserve a process for that that allows such." He went on to say, "The age and timing of these allegations leave no opportunity for due process, and that is unfair to all involved."
So Diego Morales also put out a statement this week saying, "As a husband and father, I understand sexual harassment is deplorable and can leave devastating scars. The claims being made against me," he said, "are false, and I unequivocally deny them all." Destiny Wells, in a statement, said Diego Morales' victims need to be heard and believed. She said it takes tremendous courage in coming forward. The Democratic Party this week also putting out a statement calling on former Vice President Mike Pence to cancel his fundraiser with Morales this coming week. So certainly a lot happening in that race.